I get the best seat in the house because I don't have to stand up while I speak. My junior year of high school, I was an exchange student in Austria. Spent the year there, learned a lot about myself, about what my future career would be, but I also had the chance to do a lot of traveling while I was there. My host family and I, one weekend, we went up to Salzburg, which many of you know was the birthplace of Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart, as well as the home of the von Trapp family. I don't know how many of you know the musical The Sound of Music, but it deals with the von Trapp family and their governess Maria. And Maria teaches the von Trapp children how to sing. And she teaches them how to sing by using the building blocks of any piece of music ever, do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do. Or backwards, do, ti, la, sol, fa, mi, re, do. And she states, rightly so, that any piece of music, whether it's Lila Kacht or Schlager für Melodiefestivalen, can be built using the do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do. When I thought about that, I thought that our lives are pretty much the same. Every single one of us, no matter where we are or who we are, we do the same things. As Agent Mulder in the X-Files put it, eat, sleep, defecate, procreate, that's all we do. And indeed, sometimes that feels like that's all we do. Our lives fall into a rut. We get up in the morning, we get in the shower, hopefully we take off our clothes first. We go to work, we stare at the computer screen, it stares back at us. We go home, we eat some dinner, kiss the kids goodnight, go to bed. Day in and day out, over and over, it's the same. And then our challenge is to take those building blocks and to make something extraordinary out of the daily grind. George Frederick Handel, who wrote The Messiah, if any of you know the Hallelujah chorus especially, Hallelujah, he took these building blocks and he made the same notes, the same order, but he turned the daily routine into joy to the world, or Gled Digel Jul. I want to return for the rest of my little presentation to Salzburg and Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart. And I want to play a little piece for you that shows what he did to turn the ordinary into the extraordinary. And many of you don't know this, but he wrote a series of variations based on Twinkle Lila Quernandet, or Twinkle Twinkle Little Star. But I'm going to play a few of them.